Azelaic acid for rosacea and acne, is it really that effective? Because many of the other treatments we have for acne and facial redness cause flakiness and can get your skin even more inflamed, which is what we want to avoid, right? If that's the case and you're looking for a more gentle alternative, then azelaic acid may be a good choice for you. In this video, we will look at how azelaic acid works, the strengths of azelaic acid to get the job done, as well as the other products and side effects, how long it takes to get the results in both acne and rosacea, as well as the best way to use it. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as being the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I would love for you all to gently tap on the like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider hitting that subscribe button as well. Also, if you guys are on Instagram, you could follow me there too. Now, without wasting any more time, let's get started. Azelaic acid naturally is a dicarboxylic acid that's synthesized by yeast. It has a wide variety of biological activities, making it a very versatile ingredient in skincare. And there are two things that you need to remember when it comes to how azelaic acid works. The first is that it's anti-infective, which is great for acne, and the second is that it's anti-inflammatory, which is great for rosacea. Also, if you're wondering, azelaic acid has those exfoliating properties that salicylic and glycolic have, if you're wanting to even out the skin tone and texture along the way while you're trying to treat the acne and rosacea. And it also has those brightening effects too if you're trying to fade hyperpigmentation, but obviously it will be less harsh and has less irritation than your typical acids. This is why it can be a great alternative to vitamin C serums as well, especially if you're sensitive to them. When it comes to the strength, you got your prescription strengths that come in gels and foams. Finacea is the 15% one, and Azelix, which is the 20% one, and both have been proven to be effective at treating rosacea, especially if you're experiencing those papules and pustules with your rosacea. Same goes for that stubborn acne vulgaris. The 20% azelaic acid cream was equally effective as the 0.05 tretinoin cream in reducing the number of comedones, and was actually better tolerated than the retinoid. But what about for non-prescription azelaic? Because the problem with the prescription ones are that it's getting harder and harder for them to get covered by insurance. Well, there are two products that I recommend: the ordinary 10% azelaic acid suspension and the 10% one by Paula's Choice. For rosacea, I would go with the ordinary one since it doesn't contain a bunch of other ingredients, mainly the active and a bunch of different silicones to help the product glide on your face. But for acne and dark spots, go with the Paula's Choice 10%. Also, if you're on the more oilier side too, since it also contains a little bit of salicylic acid, allantoin to help calm down the skin, and licorice extract, which is your natural skin lightener. When it comes to side effects, it's important to mention that azelaic acid is one of the most safest skin ingredients you could try. But with that said, some common side effects you may or may not experience would be mild skin irritation, redness, dryness, and over time as your body adjusts to the medication, the less of these side effects you should experience. And as always, a good rule of thumb, I always recommend this, to patch test the products first before applying on a full face. Inside the arm is actually a good place to test out the product first. And I know you're probably wondering, how long would it take to start working? For acne and rosacea, some people may see a benefit within 4 to 6 weeks. And for hyperpigmentation, it could even be as little as a week to see noticeable changes. In terms of when you can call it a bust, because a lot of people try products out and just throw them away, I would try sticking with it for about 3 months before deciding whether or not it works for you. I know a lot of times we tend to stop a lot earlier because we want those results faster. Everyone is different, which is why I recommend waiting those 3 months with azelaic acid. When it comes to how to use it, it's quite simple. First, wash your face with a gentle cleanser, then your toner if you use one, then your hyaluronic acid if you use one, then apply a thin layer of the azelaic acid solution to your face. If you're using with other products, follow the normal standard rules of layering. Apply the thinnest or water-based product first, followed by a heavier or oil-based product. Be sure to follow this with a moisturizer though, as well as a sunscreen with at least SPF 30 if you're going to be outside. I really do hope that this video was helpful. Click the subscribe button down below if you found any value in this, and comment down below too what your thoughts are on azelaic acid. Has it helped you in any way? And until then guys, I'll see you on the next one.